As you can see, we are right outside Lukaskirche and the doors are open. We are inviting people to come inside and to pray with us here. The bells of the church invite people. Yes, we are open and it is permitted that people can enter the church and pray silently. Right after Easter, and the coming Sunday is called like newborn babies, so like newborn babies yearning for milk, so we yearn for God's word. And like the disciples slowly discover the mystery of Christ's resurrection, so we also discover this mystery that Jesus is alive.
You called me from the grave by name. You called me out of all my shame. I see the old is passed away. The new has come. Now I have resurrection power. Living in the light of your goodness, you have given us freedom.
Acts 13, verse 37. But him who God raised from the dead did not see putrefaction. May God bless this word to us all. Amen. Parvane is a young girl who is living in Leipzig. Born in Iran, she saw on TV what Easter was all about. Nice chocolates, Easter bunnies, and Easter eggs. And as she saw on TV, so it was. The Easter bunnies and Easter eggs were not only very nice to look at, but really tasty. Parvane loved Easter. But in the year 2020, everything was different. The shops were closed, the markets too. The egg hunt did not happen, so also the gatherings with families was not possible. But most of all, Parvane was sad because of the news. So many people died, especially in Iran. And she thought about her family, her grandparents. What would happen to them? What would happen to us? Parvane thought and cried. Parvane's mother took her in her arms and had a suggestion. For this Easter, we're going to see a Christian service on TV. And this they did. During that service, the pastor kept on repeating, "And we must rise. We must rise from winter sleep, rise from depression, rise from the marriage crisis, rise from the pandemic of Corona." And Parvane thought to herself, "Why must we rise and stand up whenever there is a crisis?" She couldn't understand much of that sermon. But then the pastor intoned, "He is risen." And the congregation answered, "He is risen indeed." Parvane looked at the cross and thought to herself, "Someone who dies like that is really dead. And life is not possible after that. So if life is possible after such a death, this really is a true resurrection and must be really something different." She thought a long while about this. Then she looked at her mother and saw that her mother was wiping a tear from her cheek. She asked her mother, "Why are you crying?" And the mother answered, "Because at last I have understood the meaning of Easter." Parvane, her mother, together with the woman at the grave of Jesus, together with all the disciples, including Thomas and Paul, all of them have this in common. Slowly, one after the other, they understand Jesus is risen. He is risen indeed, and he is alive. And this changes their lives. The women leave their perfumes at the graveside and tell it to everyone. The disciples travel throughout the world, especially Thomas and Paul too, because they know Jesus is alive and still alive. This is the meaning of Easter. Amen. Almighty God, you have given your salvation to the world through the miracle of the resurrection of your Son. We ask you, let us also have complete freedom and come to eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives with the Father and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen.